All my most traumatic memories of Plebs centre around the times we've been naked and various things happened, like that one where you checked up.
We're doing this.
Yeah.
Where well, you I guess checked I've up just my... sold out.
I had to jump on a centurion's back because you were fighting with him, but I was completely naked, so I jumped on him and we rehearsed it, and I was wearing a dressing gown, and I said, and I was on his back like this, and I went, Sam, I'm a little bit worried actually that when the camera's down behind me like that, it's just going to be able to see, because my legs are really stretched around him, like it's going to see literally up inside my bumhole.
Like a cat.
Like a cat's bumhole. And before I'd even finished the last syllable, my bumhole, he's like, he grabs the dressing gown and he's got his head up there, like it inches away from my anus.
And I don't want to belittle you here. I don't want this to turn into a Me Too moment, but I was trying to help you out.
That's his logic. Yeah. He thinks that's completely reasonable.
I was trying to help you out.
That's how it works. That's what TV is, mate.
Works.
Get over it.
And that's
or
drop
a f- on you.
Plebs. Oh,
I've apologised to him privately. Ryan's hair, Grumio's hair, was Ryan's own hair for the first series, and he grew it out, and it looked fantastic. And then he said, do you think they could get a wig like this? Is that how it went down?
Yeah, and then they crafted a wig like of an exact representation of my hair, which was like a real milestone for me.
And again, we're like, selling Grumio wigs if anyone is interested.
Yeah, yeah.
10 grand again.
Or I could probably just
same price as the Danny Dyer.
We're in by Ryan.
I could probably just cut your hair into that shape for a fiver, to be honest. Sounds like a joke, doesn't it?
Well, they love Grumio. They love the bowl haircut. What is it that you think really connects with the fans about Grumio?
I've got no idea. I thought no one's going to get this at all. It's just like me doing an impression of my nan. I don't know why it works, but everyone's gone for it. Yeah. Yeah. My nan used to be like, you go into her house, like when ripped jeans started being a fashion, go into her kitchen, she'd be like, Get out my kitchen with them bloody shitty jeans. and now I think, like, it's just, like, gone into it, you know.
Yeah. You know the new Slave? That's a quality episode. With and when Grumio's like, he were a twat, so I shat in his hat. That is... That's classic Plebs. If anyone wants to see just one line of Plebs, just watch that. You get the show. You get it. Fine.
Yeah.
My favourites are any bit that I get to work with Keller, our stunt director, who is like a very alpha male. And as I am not an alpha male, we clash, interestingly, in that he'll be like, because he wants you to be like, he works with Tom Cruise all the time, so there's no wonder like I'm a massive disappointment to him. But I just feel like he's my dad all over again, and I'm like, sorry, I just can't do it. And he's like, one day I was like, we were waiting between takes, and I was just like bopping around doing like a stupid dance or something, and he went, Ryan, come over here, man, why you don't want to be big man, why you don't want to be action hero? And I was like, this encapsulates what I can't explain. There's no way of explaining.
Is that the same guy that just, when you were talking to some of the SAs, he just came and started doing press-ups?
Yeah. He wasn't getting very much attention, so he walked in front of us. I mean, he's huge, and he's incredibly skilled at his job, but on Plebs, he's just like, there's not much for him to do. So sometimes he'll just enter and just do a few press-ups just to show you his boss.
Rather than having a situation where Grumio can't come to work and we have to sort of keep everyone apart, we just wanted a kind of like, you know, a sort of playroom where we can just chuck all our ideas and sort of have fun. And it's really helpful for that.
I would guess that a secondary reason might also be because the weather is so erratic out there that like it always nearly so like one series, we're sitting there in a tent and it's like torrential rain outside, and we had to have our feet up like this because there's like rivers of water coming underneath. And everyone knows that like one more day of this and the whole series is like absolutely and the producer Teddy walks past the tent and he did in slow motion, I went Teddy, everything going alright? And he went, this, because he was just like a man on the verge sort of thing. Yeah, so I would guess that that's maybe...
Yeah, it's mainly weather-based. There's no creative reason. it's basically, that's what you're looking for. It's based on the weather.
Salve, Grumio.
All right, woman dressed as Lara Croft, Tomb Raider. Essentially.
Would you say that Grumio's relationship has gone more from being a slave to a friend to Marcus?
Ooh. I don't know, because sometimes you really, like... but also, they were brought up together, effectively, as brothers. So, I mean, don't dig too deep into the backstory.
No, I mean, it's there.
Yeah. They were brought up together as brothers, so I think it is quite, you know, fraternal, sibling-y sort of thing, would you say?
Yeah, in the sort of pleb spark notes analysis, I guess... We've talked a little bit how Grumio has developed a little bit more status in the later series, and he's kind of getting a little bit more above Marcus in a lot of his highfalutin. So, I mean, you're kind of powerful now, aren't you? In a way that at the start it was a lot more like I called him a little shit and he didn't do anything, and now he's had a few storylines where he kind of he's kind of in his abject laziness, he is becoming a sort of equal. I mean, Marcus is always going to be in charge, don't worry about it, I'll still put him in his place. But, yeah, no, the power, there's a power shift. And I'm not entirely sure I'm happy about it, actually, yeah.
He was the one getting all the groupies in the band. So.
Good question, actually, yeah. Well, we'll find out later tonight, won't we?
Yeah, yeah.
Comic-Con, baby. I'll be an
N4.
I know this is not like inside the actor's studio, but I started off initially playing it like he's sort of quite leaden and like a sort of stone where like everything just, he's like zen, like everything just goes over him, you know what I mean? Like this, that first few episodes particularly, he was just like absolutely sort of stoic, catatonic. But then we found a little bit that that means that you can't have any, you can't go anywhere as a character, you know, you can't sort of been charging in plot lines, so you have to make the character have a little bit more edge to them, sort of thing, a little bit more dynamism, yeah. It's just poo and bum jokes.
Why don't you write it? Yeah. I mean, there's no need for us, really. No, just get on, just go out and, I mean, that's how he'd have it. Film it on his smartphone.
Well, I've made some suggestions.
He has made some suggestions.
They largely centre around me.
Yeah. So we went out for dinner with ITV, and they're talking about future series and what we could do. And Ryan has this idea. It's Grumio in a barrel at sea, and Grumio ends up on a desert island, and then Grumio had to survive. And I say, you know, there were a couple of other people in the sitcom, but he'd forgotten them.
Yeah. And there's a big dance, and a musical number, and it's half an hour.
Grumio does have, like, a fan base. You see on Twitter and Facebook, quite a lot of people say, I know this sounds weird, but... I've got a major crush on Grumio, and Ryan's... Why
story
do they have
life.
To do the first part?
Yeah. But I appreciate it.
Ryan, could you say hi to my mate Burhan, because he couldn't get a day off today to see you?
Where is he, though?
He's at work, counting money for Deloitte.
No, I get that, but... how will he know?
A friend is filming.
Oh, hello, Burhan. Sorry you couldn't be here, but I mean, we're having a great time without you, frankly.
Thank you.
You'll
help you.
Been I found you in the rubbish, but you're not rubbish. In fact, you're really great. Oh, Ben. Won't you go to sleep now? Please just go to sleep now. It's getting...
Please just...
Please just shut your face!